Do you want to learn how to create an app similar to Netflix without breaking the bank and in a short amount of time? Maybe you have an idea of developing a Netflix clone or developing a video streaming app with cutting-edge technologies like IoT devices, VR, AR, or AI as your secret ingredient. Stay with me and I'll share a step-by-step guide on how to achieve this, as well as some common deadly mistakes you have to avoid and clever tricks to keep your customers happy and how to make your app profitable from the day one. My name is Dennis Babich and I'm the director of a software development company. In today's video, I will be sharing my knowledge and expertise of my team and my clients with you on how to create an app that's similar to Netflix. So, let's get started. To start, we need to identify 10 essential steps for creating a successful Netflix clone and put them in the right order. Missing any of these steps can lead you to a failure, resulting in wasted time and money. The truth is, the cost of creating an app can vary significantly, starting from $3,000 up to $20,000, $100,000 and beyond. And we need to identify the difference between each cost and decide which type of app makes the most sense for your specific purposes at this stage. Alright, let's kick things off with basics of a Netflix app and what features it includes. The Netflix ecosystem have a mobile app, web app, TV app and the admin zone. Mobile app, web app, and TV have many similar features, such as search functionality, my list, video downloads, parent controls, video quality settings, recommendation algorithm, feedback system, and an account management functionality that lets you manage your subscriptions and profile. In the web admin zone, you'll find various functions to manage your users, content, analytics, billing and payments, security settings, and user support. You can also set up localization and partner management. Naturally, not all of these features are necessary for your video streaming app. So how do you determine the core functionalities? This is where a lean canvas business plan comes in play, helping you identify your unique advantages. Netflix, for example, revolutionized the industry by leveraging a few disruptive business models that gave them a significant edge. Firstly, they offered an all-in-one solution where users could access all their TV shows in one place by paying a single monthly subscription. Secondly, they implemented a tailored recommendation algorithm that increased user engagement and retention. Lastly, Netflix produced their own original content, setting themselves apart from the competition. Using the Lean Canvas business plan, you can identify your target audience, their needs, and provide customized solutions that will disrupt the existing market. By jotting down your business plan on a napkin, you can quickly produce your software and focus your attention on the most important aspects of your project. If you have any questions, ideas, or concerns, feel free to drop them in the comments below. I personally check all comments and I'm happy to help you with your questions because I truly enjoyed helping my audience achieve their goals. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Next up is the value proposition. Once you know how to create a video streaming app like Netflix, you need to nail your product market fit for a successful launch. This involves creating value proposition for your target audience, which means understanding their biggest problems so that you can build the best solution for each of them. One idea is to create a Netflix clone subscription-based app for fitness coaches and their audience, similar to Spotify, but for fitness videos. Users are struggling with high price for HIIT workout courses. Another problem is how to begin doing this workout if you're alone or you don't have motivation to go to gym, or how to find the best workout for you where you can see the results of people that have similar weight and complexity as you. But imagine creating a platform where users can find and create a fitness program tailored to their needs. For example, the platform like Spotify where you can find tons of videos from different coaches and their programs in one place just for 10 bucks per month. And on top of that, you can watch the live stream of your favorite coach and do HIIT workout with other users with video where they will motivate you. Or for example, the system that will sort different workouts according to your parameters, beginners, experienced, and your body institution, where you can see results of other people who managed to finish this course and see the line that you can have also a strong body in 50 days and you just have to start this specific course. Pretty cool, huh? When using a value proposition canvas, you should identify the biggest value you can bring to the table for your audience and their needs and highlight it. If you're interested on getting more valuable insights regarding startups and businesses and wish to become a part of a community of business founders where I regularly share useful information and engage in live chats, feel free to click in the link in the video description and join my Discord channel. During your research on competitions, it's important to examine the largest companies in the industry, such as Netflix, Amazon Prime, Hulu, Disney Plus, and others. You should also look for features and functionalities that could be beneficial to your own app. Additionally, a helpful life hack is to explore successful video streaming startups in other countries and adapt their ideas or processes to your own market. This can be a great way to find innovative solution and stay ahead of the curve. Using story mapping, you can efficiently choose the essential features to build your MVP rapidly and prioritize functions that can be executed and launched quickly. The minimum viable product is crucial. If you find these tips helpful, please consider subscribe to my channel and liking this video. Your support will help increase its visibility in the YouTube algorithm. Okay, your objective now is to identify the key features and essential functionality for your minimum viable product, MVP. It's crucial to release your product quickly and move on the next phase. I still remember when we created a video streaming platform with a $3,000 budget and a minimum UI using a third-party video streaming software provider. Guess what? Our client showed the product to their users, received positive feedback, and raised 150 grand within a month. That's exactly what you should do. Identify the essential and create an MVP quickly. To help you with this, keep in mind two important things. First, the market is not waiting. If you hesitate or have concerns, your competitors may execute their plans and leave you behind. If you have any questions, concern, leave a comment and I'll assist you. Secondly, use the agile development process for your business and software development actions. Relying fully on one iteration and luck is not sufficient. Your job is to identify essential features, create the MVP, show the product to customers, receive the feedback from your audience as a proof that your product has value, and then return to the idea stage to make improvements to your product and repeat the process. It's really simple. When your customers will start paying for your product, angel investors will line up and show their high interest in investing in your app. After conducting your value proposition research, it's important to create a wireframe map to organize your ideas into a basic flow and identify any missing user cases or scenarios. For instance, let's take our Netflix-like app for fitness coaches, which might include basic use cases, such as a list of video programs, program pages, download functionality, and more. Missing use cases, like what should happen if your coach forgets to upload their program for a video course. By creating a wireframe map, you can ensure that your app's users' experience is well throughout and includes all the necessary features for your audience. If you're not sure where to start, try mapping out the user journey for a particular use case, such as discovering and sign up for a program. From there, you can expand and refine your map as needed. UI design can be a relatively easy aspect of app development, By comparing major platforms like Netflix, Hulu, and Disney+, you will notice they share a simple design centered around the video feed. This functionality is often considered the most valuable feature of a video streaming app. Your focus should be on creating a clean, straightforward design that centers around your unique, valuable feature without any unnecessary distractions. Here's a pro tip. Check out websites like Behance or Dribbble for inspiration on Netflix app design. Search for video streaming apps and take inspiration from the best artists by borrowing elements that you like. When developing a software application, it's important to choose the right tech stack from the beginning. This will help ensure that your app stays modern and updated regularly to meet the fast-changing demands of your audience. However, if you choose the wrong tech stack, it can cause a variety of problems, such as difficulty changing developers, painfully slow user interface, non-scalable and non-maintainable cloud infrastructure, high costs, payment issues, and risks of your entire app going offline if traffic spikes. If you're planning to develop a Netflix clone, it's crucial to select the right tech stack to create your minimum viable product fast. Using native Swift for iOS and Kotlin for Android will give your app possibility to work smoothly with video streaming functionality and languages and frameworks such as Python, Django, Node.js, and Amazon Web Services for your backend will help you produce your software quickly and on time. Third-party services such as Wowza for video streaming, Stripe for payment processing, Twilio for SMS and SendGrid for emails can also help increase your speed. However, it's important to stay away from overhyped technologies that are difficult to manage, such as PHP, Ruby, React Native, and .NET. These technologies are not suitable for video streaming apps, and they may and will cause more problems than they solve. Because of the video stream in your app, it can eat a lot of your phone's memory, along with controllers and even a chat feature. That's why frameworks like React Native may not be able to tackle these problems efficiently. Remember that your goal is to choose the right tech stack at each stage of your software development process. Don't overdo it at the beginning, but think in advance about what you will need in the future based on your future features set. When you're designing your app architecture, choosing the right tech stack, it's like getting a proper diagnosis after a blood test. It's essential for your app's success. I understand the difficulty of working alone at times, which is why I've created a Discord business community for startup founders. Here, you can seek advice and gain valuable business insights. The link to the community is provided in the video description below, so don't hesitate to join us. When it comes to finding a freelancer or agency to help you with your software development, it can be overwhelming to weigh all the pros and cons. But perhaps the most important factor to consider is not just who are you hiring, but what value they can bring to the table. Instead of just focusing on who you're hiring, you should rather focus on the mindset, expertise, and value that your potential technical partner can bring to your business. By focusing on finding a technical partner, you can reap additional benefits beyond just software development. In addition to getting your app created, you can also receive stress testing for your idea, valuable business advice, networking support, assistance with decision making, and a focus on user needs. Moreover, a technical partner can also help you with creating your MVP fast, which will not only save your time and money, but also increase your chances of securing investments quickly and easily. When it comes to pricing, it's important to keep in mind that some agencies may try to sell you a Netflix clone for 10 or 20K. However, you should consider how many customers have already purchased the same codebase, whether it's scalable, and if it's writing with good code architecture and guidelines. You should also have confidence that this code is your intellectual property. After the Twitch code leak, many companies were able to obtain the code and resell it. It could even be illegal if you purchase an existing clone. Anyway, the most expensive part is not creating the code. It's actually finding clients for your app. Creating an app like Netflix is not rocket science and can easily be done by your technical partner. Let's take a look at the price of an MVP and how much it may cost. In the following table, you can find the prices for agencies in the US, EU, and Ukraine. By comparing these prices, you can realize that Ukraine offers the best value for money. With great English communication skills, extensive experience in outsourcing projects worldwide, and the trust of global companies such as GitLab, Grammarly, Jubel, and many others, Ukrainian developers are the best option to reduce your expenditures. The second way to reduce your expenses is by creating a minimum viable product and focusing on the essential features you need. The right technical partner can help you with that. Standard software agencies tend to focus on digital transformation and add many features as possible, squeezing your budget. The third way is by choosing the right tech stack, as I mentioned before, which can save you a lot of money. Lastly, the first method is an agile methodology, which you should use in your business to move from one MVP to the next. This approach will help you save money on software development, marketing, and other expenses. Okay, let's talk about Agile. The Agile can be a powerful tool for increasing speed, but did you know that in some situations, it can actually slow down a project by up to 30%? Consider a team of 5 developers who know their tasks and responsibilities, communicate well, and have built most of the product. With simple tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs, and short meetings, they can have a highly effective process. It sounds too good to be true, right? However, as the team grows to 15 or more people, unexpected problems can arise. Key developers may leave the team. The onboarding process will become complex and time-consuming. Team productivity may fail. Communication issues may happen more often. Deadlines and delivery dates may be pushed out. Code and architecture quality may decrease. To avoid these issues, you'll need to hire a tech lead to manage the team and code architecture. Hire a technical project manager. Set up processes like Scrum, Sprints, Backlog, and Retrospective. Run a daily stand-ups and update on pending tasks. Use more advanced tools like Jira for management and velocity. As I mentioned earlier, using the proper tools at the right time can help you achieve your MVP faster. However, using the same tools without proper knowledge and expertise can lead to a failure. Never ever forget about your users and analytics. Paying attention to metrics such as unique visitors, user behaviors, and common sessions is crucial. Tools like Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, and Mixpanel can help you figure out what's going on. Regular health checks will help you find out what needs improvement and identify hidden client needs. All right. If you're planning to create a video streaming app like Netflix and you need a technical partner that can help you with that, feel free to schedule a 30-minute call with me where we can discuss your idea, your business goals, and how to turn your idea into a winner. See ya!